All right. Thanks so much for either thinking about purchasing a Fozzy Football game board or actually having taken the leap and purchasing one. What I want to talk to you today is all of the instructions you're going to need to get started playing Fozzy Football. Everything from downloading the app to playing the game to the ins and outs of Fozzy and then ultimately determining a winner. So let's get started. The clock. So let's talk about the game clock first. There's 15 minutes on the clock, perfect amount of time for a competitive game. Now there are two levels of play. There is a competitive and a casual game. Competitive game comes with a 15 second play clock to keep you honest and keep the game moving. Casual game lets you play at your own pace. Now there are timeouts that you can call too. Each team's allocated two timeouts. You can use those anytime during the game and stop the clock for as long as you'd like. Start of play. All right, let's talk about starting play in Fozzy Football. The red team is considered the home team, so they're gonna slide the first puck. We're gonna assume that there was a kickoff and a touchback, so the line of scrimmage starts at the 25-yard line. From there, you're gonna slide your first puck, either aiming at the run targets or the pass targets. You get four downs to advance 10 yards. You're gonna repeat that all the way down the field. The object of the game. So the object of the game is exactly that of American rules football. You start with your line of scrimmage on the 25-yard line, you get four downs to advance 10 yards, and you keep moving towards your opponent's end zone. Once you get in the end zone, that's a touchdown. If you get a hanger, no matter where you are in the field of play, that is a touchdown, no matter where the line of scrimmage is. Puck slides. So how do you move your line of scrimmage up the field in Fozzy Football? You slide the puck. You're either aiming at the run targets or the pass targets. If you come up short on a run target, you're stopped for a loss, minus two. Come up short on the pass targets and you're sacked, minus six. Throw it off the back of the board, incomplete. And if you're aiming for run targets, a throw off the back of the board is no gain. It's that simple. Fourth down. All right, it's fourth down. What are you gonna do? You're either gonna have to go for it, you're gonna punt, or you're gonna kick a field goal. So if you go for it, usually you wanna do that with short yardage. If it's long yardage, you have a decision to make. Do you want to punt or kick a field goal? If your line of scrimmage is at the 45-yard line or closer, you have to try or attempt the field goal. If you're further than the 45, at that point, you're probably going to decide to punt. Defense. Let's talk about defenders. You can choose to use defenders to make the game of Fozzy Football a little bit more difficult. In the beginning, if you haven't had a lot of experience playing the game, then you're probably not going to want to use defenders. As you get better, you can choose to put either one, two, or three defenders on the field to increase the difficulty level of play. Let's talk about penalties. All right, let's talk about penalties. If your puck slide lands in one of the bubbles that is associated with a penalty, that's going to back your line of scrimmage up and you just repeat the down.
Scoring.
All right, scoring. How do we determine scoring in Fozzy Football? There's basically four ways to score. A safety, a field goal, a touchdown, or a PAT. I'm gonna break down each one of those areas for you. So how does a safety happen in Fozzy Football? If you're at the 6-yard line or closer to your own end zone, you're in the danger area. So if you're at the 6-yard line and your puck slide comes up short and you're attempting to get the pass targets, that means you're sacked, minus six, backs your line of scrimmage up into the end zone, that's a safety. 2 points for the other team, and you're gonna restart with a punt from your 20-yard line. So when can you attempt a field goal in the game? Basically, if your line of scrimmage is at the 45-yard line or closer, you're in field goal range, and you can attempt a field goal on any down. Most commonly, field goals are attempted on fourth down, and so what you do is slide at the kicking targets. If you get a kicking target that corresponds with your line of scrimmage, then your field goal is good. 3 points on the board, possession changes, your opponent gets the ball at the 25, and they're coming back at you. So how do you score a touchdown in Fozzy Football? There's basically two ways to do it. One, by advancing your line of scrimmage up the field until you actually reach your opponent's end zone. The other is by getting a hanger. You slide your puck and it's hanging off the back edge of the table, then that is a touchdown, considered a hanger, no matter where your line of scrimmage is. A touchdown's 6 points, and now we're gonna talk about PATs. So a PAT, basically points after touchdown, there's two outcomes that can happen. You can either kick for one extra point or you can go for two. Going for two is a little more difficult. And in this case, you gotta slide your puck either for a 6-yard run or an 8-yard pass. either of those, you get 2 points on the board. Who wins? So how do you determine a winner in Fozzy football? At the end of the expiration of the game clock, when 15 minutes has expired, you're basically gonna say, who has the most points? That's your winner. Now what happens if the game is tied? You go into a sudden death overtime, and the way I like to do it, rock, paper, scissors, whoever wins that throws the first puck. Whoever gets the first hanger is your sudden death winner. The puck in the dead center has a crosshair, and those crosshairs are what determines the result of your puck slide. So in this case, if the crosshairs, let's get a top shot of that guy, has landed in the 12-yard area, a 12-yard pass, then the result of your slide is 12 yards. If the crosshairs is over one of the penalty targets, like that, the dead center of the puck, in this case, corresponds with a false start, minus 5 yards. Let's briefly talk about the target areas. These are your scoring zones. On the left side of the board, these are your run targets. On the right side of the board are your pass targets. In the pass targets, there are actually two turnovers, and these are your interception bubbles. On the left side of the board, there are also two turnovers, and these are your fumble targets. The center circle of the target area is for kicking, either for field goals or for punts. In the case of a field goal, if you get a puck in the center circle, that is a field goal that is good up to 55 yards. 45, 35, if you're outside of the target area, your field goal is no good. For punts, center circle is a 60-yard punt, 50, 40, the worst punt possible is a 30. So that's it. You've reached the end of this instructional, and now you know how to play the game of Fozzy football. Simple, isn't it? Thanks so much for purchasing your game board. Thanks for visiting us online at www.fozzyfootball.com. If you have any questions that we haven't covered in this instructional, you can reach out to us by clicking the link for support, and we'll get right back to you with an answer.